We're good, buddy.
Joanna.
Welcome. Thank you all for coming to the 5th annual talent show for Mary McLeod Parish. It's a really good time for everyone to get together and have an enjoyable evening. And we have quite a few talents to display this evening. Some piano and guitar playing, some poems and songs, and then some skits. There will be a sign for the seminarians to hold up to let you know when to clap for the skits. And I'm just filling in here, as you can see from your program. There's a different master of ceremonies listed. We couldn't find anyone by that name, so I was asked to fill in. We're going to begin with the younger children, and the first performance will be Sister Mary Josephine's kindergarten class. They will be doing a poem, Jesus Our Savior.
Thank you.
number 8. Tick-tock, tick-tock, it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. My watching its pendulum swing to and fro, many hours had he spent while a boy. And in childhood and manhood the clock seemed to know and to share both his grief and his joy. For it struck 24 as he entered the door with a blooming and beautiful bride. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, tick-tock, tick-tock, it slept. Seconds numbering, tick-tock, tick-tock, it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. My grandfather said that of those he could hire, not a servant so faithful he found. For wages in no time it had bought one desire at the close of each week to be wound. For it kept in its place not a frown upon its face, and its hands never hung by its side. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, tick-tock, tick-tock, it slept. Seconds numbering, tick-tock, tick-tock, it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. It rang an alarm in the dead of the night, and an alarm that for years had been dumb. And we knew that his spirit was gloomy for flight, and his hour for departure had come. Still the clock kept the time with a soft and muffled chime, as we silently stood by his side. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, tick-tock, tick-tock, it slept. Seconds numbering, tick-tock, tick-tock, it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. It stopped short, never to go again.
Thank you. That Alma Redemptoris Mater chant is the chant we do, the religious and seminarians, every evening at the end of Compline night prayers during the Advent season and Christmas season. Our next piece is the song Holly Wally Doodle by Adelaide and Patrick Schindler.
Chocolate.
listen to the devil. He can be a little rebel. Sing a poem on the doodle all the day. Fare thee well, farewell, Christian gloom, be on your way. Though you haven't any money, you can simmer right, so you sing a poem on the doodle all the day.
Tongue twister to sing that. Very good. Next, we have a piano piece, Angels We Have Heard on High. That will be played by Rose Strain. Of the younger children's pieces will be Joshua Wegener on the piano playing Santa Lucia. Thank you. Now we'll move on to the performances by the teens and adults. And we have, first of all, John Wagner will be playing the piano, the piece Rondo. Thank you. the intermission to do two more songs. And so our next piano piece will be one of the minor seminarians, John Beale, who will be performing Lost Boy, an arrangement of Peter Pan. Seminarian Marcel Mansfield, he will be playing a song entitled Innocent. going to continue with the performances by the teens and adults. We have a few choral performances and then several skits to conclude our program this evening. Our next piece is a choral piece sung by Perpetua Wagoner, O del mio dolce ardor. Singing two choir pieces. The first will be sung a cappella, Jesu Rex Admirabilis, and the second hymn, Hail, O Queen of Heaven and Throne, will be sung with the piano accompaniment. And just so you know, if you hear any bad notes on the piano, it's just that Frater Martin sang a bad note and I'm trying to match.
You
Moving on to a what must be a scary skit. Gracie gets the driver's license by Joseph, Ina, Joseph Jr. and Bridget Strain.
Mrs. Burns?
Yes?
I'd like to talk to you about getting a driver's license.
All right. I'm having a little trouble getting one for myself, so I can't help you.
No, honey, he didn't mean that. What he meant was that.
I believe I can tell her what I mean. So, I've been going over this test, and, never in my 16 years have I ever seen anything like it.
Thank you.
So, when you wrote these answers, I'm sure you had something in mind. I'd like to find out what it was.
All right. Isn't he nice, Blanche?
Take this question, for instance. Have you ever had a driver's license before? How long?
Well, it's about this long. It fits right in my wallet.
No, the gentleman means, how long have you had your driver's license?
Is your name Mrs. Burns?
No, sir.
Then kindly let her do her own talking.
All right, I will. When you need my help, I'll be in the blue car in the parking lot. Good luck, honey.
Blanche isn't really mad at girls. She wouldn't have called you honey.
May we get on with this?
All right.
Now, if you've had a driver's license before, you must know something about the California traffic laws.
Well, of course.
Okay, then how do you explain this answer? The question is, when a motorist drives up to an intersection where a pedestrian is crossing, who has the right of way? Your answer was, an ambulance.
That's right.
An ambulance?
The one that comes to pick up the pedestrian.
Pardon me a minute. See, Dan, you couldn't get a ticket for the fights tonight? Yeah? Trade places with me and I'll give you mine.
Uh-huh. I talked to her and she filled out her application.
All right. Mrs. Burns, let's try the eye test. I don't think that requires anything.
All right, but why don't you like to think?
I don't know. Take this little white card and put it over your eye. Okay. Now, have you got one eye closed?
Yes.
Now concentrate on the card. Now what do you see?
A little white card.
With the other eye.
Nothing. That's the one I got close.
All right, Mrs. Burns, with both eyes open, can you read the top line on the chart?
Oh yes, I can read all the lines, but I can't pronounce the words. The one line that makes sense is the bottom line. Union Printing Company.
Yeah. What do you know? Don't say that.
Well, sure. Come on, let's get on with the test.
Mrs. Burns, if I issue you a driver's license that never has to be renewed as long as you live, you promise not to tell anyone where you got it?
Oh, I wouldn't want you to do that. You might get in trouble. I'll just go on using the one I've got. But thanks anyway.
Mrs. Burns?
Yes?
You already have a driver's license and you're applying for another one?
Well, I wanted to get one for my other purse so I don't have to keep on changing them. Bye!
Thank you.
our next skit is we're going to switch two of them because of costuming. So we're going to move ahead to the one that's supposed to be spelled Bad Inventor. And this is by two of the minor seminarians who will be performing, David Stone and Jonathan Layman.
The bright young inventor.
Yeah, and you are?
I am Alex, your new supervisor.
So do you have any inventing experience?
No, even better. I am the owner's son. So obviously I'm perfectly qualified. So, what inventions do you have to show me?
Well, there's this. See, in the future, people are using cell phone devices. Every man and woman. And I've created a machine called voicemail.
Go on. Well,
yeah, well, you send messages to people's phones. And recorded instructions for you to do it the first time.
No, every time. We must teach them every time.
Won't they know how to do that the first time?
No, we must instruct them every time. And it won't be really, really annoying.
If you say so, well, there's this. See, in the future, people are using elevators to get around. And they'll always be rushing to get to the elevator. So I created a button called Open Door, so you can hold the door open.
Ah, yes. But then we'll make a button called Closed Door, which will do nothing.
Would it just close the door?
That's crazy talk.
Listen, Alex, how about you let me stick to inventing and you can go work like marketing or something?
Nah, the office is cleared across town and you know how bad the traffic is.
Well, how's anybody help with that? See, it's called a stoplight and it uses colors to direct the traffic.
Ah, yes, but the color for stop and the color for go will be the two colors that colorblind people can't tell apart.
These are really bad ideas.
Believe in yourself.
No, not my ideas, your ideas. You're ruining my inventions.
Nonsense, I'm trying to help you.
What is this? Don't touch that. It's an alarm clock. We'll play a soothing Beethoven music and wake up in the morning.
No, it'll make a noise like this. Bam! Bam! Bam!
Why would anybody want this?
Bam! Bam! Bam!
Stop,
bam! Bam! Ooh, what is this? This looks nice.
This is Netflix.
We'll be the home of all lousy movies.
Oh no, the TV remote.
We'll have hundreds of buttons that do nothing.
YouTube.
We'll launch the career of Justin Bieber.
No, Alex, please, I beg you.
Relax, Felix. Together, our inventions will change the world.
Well, yes, I have one invention so simple. Not even you, Croon. The bathrobe.
No, the Snuggie. No!
Seminarians is called Ophia Workshop. Louis Alvin, John Beale, Marcel Mansfield, Henry Harris, and David Stone.
Overcome your greatest fears. I have a fear myself, and that is the fear of the word which is spelt A-A-G-H, exclamation mark, that word. So we should probably introduce ourselves. How about we start with you?
My name is Jim, and I have a fear of apologies.
I'm sorry?
Apologies! I'm sorry! Any sort of apologies?
Yes!
Okay, we're gonna try to avoid them. You, what's wrong with you?
Hi, everyone. My name's Arnold, and I have a fear of things being repeated.
You have a fear of things.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You, what's wrong with you?
My name's Robert, and I have a fear of awkward silences.
So how long did these silences have to be?
That was borderline there.
Right.
That
okay. The conversation is flowing then, okay? All right.
Hey, I'm Tim. Sorry, I'm late. Ah! Oh!
That's okay. I'm going to introduce you to everybody. This is Arnold, and he has a fear of repetition.
I'm terribly sorry.
What is wrong with you?
I bark at other people's phobias.
No, seriously, what's wrong with you?
No, like a dog, I bark at other people's phobias.
How is that gonna work? This is Phobia Workshop. We all have fears.
This is a fear, too.
Alright, whatever, you're here now. My name is Arnold, or actually Theodore, and I have a fear myself. I have the fear of the word just spelt A-A-G-H, exclamation mark, that word. Let's see. This is Arnold, and he has a fear of repetition.
I guess we better keep the conversation going, eh?
Whoa.
Oh, she said
that earlier.
I'm sorry.
Can we just try and make some progress, please? This is Jim, and he has a fear of apologies.
Apparently, no.
Don't apologize. Okay. Jim, how did this all start?
Well, it all started when I first put on Victor's collar.
Final skit by seminarians Jonathan Lanen and Anthony Strain is entitled Your Name, Sir.
As a policeman.
All right, and your name is?
One second. All right.
Ready?
Yes. My name is Derek.
What are you doing?
That's my name.
What is?
This. Derek.
Derek is your name?
Yes.
A bit unusual, isn't it, mister?
I get a dollar for every time somebody said that.
All right. And how do you spell Mr.?
As it sounds.
I was wondering if you'd actually mind spelling it for me.
Could you just hurry it?
I'd be very happy if you did.
Okay. N-I-C-K-L-E.
Nickel. Nickel.
Nickel? What? Where?
N-I-C-K-L-E. E.
Hyphen E.
Hyphen E. Spells nickel. Does not spell...
Have you gotten mad? What is the matter with you? I thought the modern policeman was supposed to be a highly trained law enforcement unit. You can't even spell!
Alright, Mr. Nickel, what's your address? What's your address?
Are you talking to me?
Yes.
Oh, you want my address?
Yes.
Or do you want Mr. Nickel's address?
Just give me your address.
All right. My address is number 22.
Watch it. Watch it. Just watch it.
Watch, for heaven's sakes.
But do you realize that assaulting an officer is a very serious offense?
Oh, yes. I imagine it probably is very serious. But telling a police officer your address, on the other hand, is not so serious, is it? Or is it? Or have the laws changed since last I checked? Or perhaps the Homeland Secretary has had to take strict measures against the rising tide of people giving their address to policemen whenever they're asked to.
All right. So let me just clarify this for you. Your address is number 22.
No. It's number 22. King's Lynn.
Sorry, I thought you said number 22.
No, I didn't.
I'm sorry, I can't be down there. From some angles, it almost looks like number 22.
Oh! Oh, you don't understand.
All right, well, let's just step this way.
Okay, all of you, all of us, that didn't give a performance, thought you're getting off scot-free, but you're not.
Yeah.
We're going to sing. You can turn to the back page. Tomorrow, of course, is a Feast of Our Lady of Lourdes. This is a beautiful song about a pilgrim that goes to Lourdes, and it was made known by sung by Andy Williams, and it says the songwriter was Eula Parker. So please join in. If you don't know the melody, I'm sure you know the chorus. And so we'll sing this to conclude. I've traveled far, the land and the sea. Beautiful places I happen to be. One little town I'll never forget is Lourdes, the village of St. dishes to share for the potluck, and after Father Gabriel and Father Aloysius, if he's back there, and I give you a blessing. Those who performed can get something from the prize table, which is over on the side of the hall by the furnace room, where Mrs. Salgado is standing. And we ask you to remember to take your dishes when you go. Okay, priest can come up. Benedictio Dei Omnipotentis, Patris et Filio et Spiritus Sancti, descendat super vos et maniat semper. Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.